Today we're going to go over our plug-and-play remote start installation on a 2009 to 2017 Audi Q5. This installation takes about 10 to 15 minutes and will work immediately after installation is complete. This video will also be used as a reference video for some other models, as the wiring harness installation is exactly the same and the BCM is in identical locations in other models as well. We will not be working in the front of the vehicle at all during this installation. We're going to go to the rear of the vehicle and open the hatch. And once you guys have the hatch open, you can see over here on the passenger side of the trunk, we have a little cubby hole. You will notice at the top of that cubby, there is a turn dial, which is the lock tab for that panel. Turn that dial counterclockwise. That will loosen the panel and you guys can completely remove it from the vehicle or just fold it flat on the trunk floor. Basically want to move it out of the way so we have access to the components back behind the cubby. You will notice once that's removed, we have access to the BCM, which is right here. Our wiring harness is color-coded to the factory connectors for an easy installation. This is as far as we need to take the vehicle apart. There's no need to remove a bunch of panels or take a dash off in the front. So before we get started with the installation of the wiring harness, I'm going to go over a few things on the bench to get you guys prepped where we can just plug it in and then we'll program the module and then we'll jump over to the demo and show you guys how it works. So we're going to go ahead and prepare the wiring harness to get ready to be installed in the vehicle. So the first thing that we need to do is the key is going to have to go in the box. So the first thing we'll do is just go ahead and use a little flathead, or in my case, I got a little pry tool, and we're just going to pop the little clamps loose. We'll open this up and you guys will kind of see the coil here, which is going to set around the key. Before we insert the key, we're going to remove the battery. So go ahead and pop the actual key part out. And then this little metal tab, just kind of grab it on the top and the bottom and pull this out. You might have to kind of like use a little force and wiggle it back and forth, but this is the battery tray. So there's the battery. Just dump that out. And you want to remove the battery completely and it will not be used again. Then reassemble the key. So basically you're just going to, put it this way, pop that back in there, put the metal part of the key. So now it's reassembled without the battery. You're going to set it in the key box like this. So you'll notice that the coil is closer to the left-hand side and you want that to set right over basically kind of like the front portion of the key here, like the trunk button, if you will. So you'll set it in there like that. The metal portion is going to set back against the back side here and you'll close it up. It won't shake. There's a piece of foam in there. I don't know if you guys saw that, but it keeps it nice and secure. And then on the harness, you're going to see a little pigtail here that says key, and that just plugs right into the box here. So you'll see that we have our port. Plug it in, it'll click, give it a little tug, make sure it's secure, and that part is complete. The last thing that I want you guys to check is we have a couple jumpers up here on the harness. It may come plugged in already to the pink or the green, but on this particular vehicle, we want to make sure the pink is hooked up to the pink. So if it comes disconnected or it comes hooked to the green, just disconnect it, and it needs to look just like this. The green one, we're just going to leave it loose. Don't cut it off. Just let it sit there. And now we are ready to install this in the vehicle. And then for you push button start guys, you are going to have this adapter that you'll need to plug in that says push button start only. So for you key port guys, this will not be used. The push button start guys, this will be used at the BCM, and then the other end will plug right into our remote start module like the other end of our harness here. So what we're going to do is jump in the vehicle now and we're going to show you guys how to plug this stuff in. The vehicle that we're working on is a Keyport vehicle, so this blue adapter will not be used, but I wanted to touch on it here in the video. So if you guys do have an actual button that you push to start your vehicle, this will be required. Otherwise, that gets set aside. So what we're going to do is unplug the brown connector from the BCM first. It's always the first one to get unplugged and the last one to get plugged back in. Then we're going to go ahead and unplug the gray connector. and then go ahead and unplug the black connector with the pink tab here. So what we're going to do is plug the factory connector into our harness and then plug the other end of our harness right back into the BCM. And remember, the brown connector is always the first one to get unplugged and the last one to get plugged back in. Please refer to the module programming video for the most up-to-date programming procedure and also for proper connection of the wiring harness to the module.
All right, so on the factory key, we're gonna go ahead and hit the lock button three times. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3. We're gonna give it a few seconds here and let her fire up. Once she's running and you're ready to get in and drive away, you can hit the unlock button on the factory key. You're gonna open the door. You'll jump in here, make sure you close the door, and then you're gonna go ahead and put the key in the port. You're not gonna push it all the way to start. You're just going to simply set it in here to the first click right there. You're gonna press and release the brake pedal, and we're still running, as you can see over here on the tack. And then you can pull it out of park, put it in drive, and drive away.